Lesson 20, Whose Forest? This is Suryamani's story. And this is a true story. Suryamani is a girl star. Girl Stars is a project which tells extraordinary tales of ordinary girls who have changed their lives by going to school. Daughter of the Jungle. Look at the picture. Where do you think these children are off to with little bundles on the sticks? When you find out, you too would want to go with them. The children are going to the forest. There they jump, run, climb trees and sing songs in the language called Kuduk. They pick the fallen flowers and leaves to weave them into necklaces. They enjoy the wild fruits. They look for birds whose calls they imitate. Joining them in all this fun is their favorite Didi, Suryamani. Every Sunday, Suryamani takes the children to the forest. As they move around, she shows them how to recognize the trees, the plants, and animals. Children enjoy this special class in a forest. Suryamani always says to learn to read the forest is as important as reading books. She says, we are forest people, Adivasis. Our lives are linked to the forest. If the forests are not there, we too will not remain. Growing up, Suryamani loves the forest since she was a child. She would not take the direct road to school, but would choose the path through the forest. Suryamani's father had a small field. Her family used to collect leaves and herbs from the forest and sell these in the bazaar. Her mother would weave baskets from bamboo and make leaf plates out of the fallen leaves. But now, no one can pick up a single leaf from the forest. That is since Shambhu, the contractor, came there. The people of Suryamani's village were afraid of the contractor. Everyone except Budhiyamai. She would say, we the people of this forest have a right over it. We look after our forest. We don't cut trees like these contractors do. The forest is like our collective bank, not yours or mine alone. We take from it only as much as we need. We don't use all our wealth. Suryamani's father could no longer support the family on the small land. He moved to the town in search of work, but things did not improve. Sometimes there would be no food in the house. At times, Maniya Chacha, uncle, would send some grain from his small shop to Suryamani's house. Chacha tried hard and got admission for Suryamani in the school of Bisanpur. Here, they would not have to pay for the fees, uniforms and books. Suryamani would have to stay there and study. Suryamani didn't want to leave her village and forest. But Maniya Chacha was firm. If you do not study, what will you do? Go hungry? Suryamani would argue. Why should I go hungry? The jungle is there to help. Chacha tried to explain. But we are being moved away from our forest. Even the forests are disappearing. In the place, mines are being dug, dams are being built. Believe me, it is not important for you to study to understand about the laws. Maybe then you can help to save our forest. Young Suryamani listened and tried to understand some of what he said. Suryamani's journey. Suryamani was filled with joy on seeing the school at Bisanpur. The school was near a thick forest. Suryamani studied hard and passed her BA after getting a scholarship. She was the first girl in the village to do this. While she was in college, she met Vasavi Didi, a journalist. Suryamani soon joined her to work for the Jharkhand Jungle Bachao Andolan, movement to save the forest of Jharkhand. This work took Suryamani to far-off towns and cities. Her father did not like this, but Suryamani continued her work. Not only that, she also started to fight for the rights of the village people. Her childhood friend Bijoy helped her in this work. Suryamani had another friend, Mirchi, who stayed with her day and night. Suryamani would share all her thoughts and dreams with Mirchi. Mirchi would listen and say, "Ki, ki." Suryamani had a dream for her Kuduk community. She wanted all the people to feel proud of being Adivasis. Suryamani's Torang. Suryamani was 21 when she opened a center with the help of Vasavi Didi and others. She called it Torang, which means jungle in the Kuduk language. Suryamani wanted that on festivals, people should sing their own song. They should not forget their music and should enjoy wearing the traditional clothes. Children should also learn about herbs, medicines, and the art of making things from bamboo. Children should learn the language of school, but must link it with their own language. All this happens in the Torang Center. Many special books about the Kuduk community and other Adivasis have been collected. Flutes and different types of drums are also kept there. Whenever something is unfair or if someone is afraid that his land and livelihood would be taken away, they turn to Suryamani. Suryamani fights for everyone's right. Suryamani and Bijoy have got married and work together. Today, the work is praised by many people. She is invited even to other countries to share her experiences. People of her area are also raising their voice for a new forest law, which is Right to Forest Act 2007. That means people who have been living in the forest for at least 25 years have the right over the forest land and what is grown on it. They should not be removed from the forest. The work of protecting the forest should be done by the Gram Sabha. Lottery for farming in Mizoram. We have read about the forest of Jharkhand in Suryamani's story. Now, we will read about the forest on the hills of Mizoram. Let's see how people live there and how farming is done. As soon as the school bell rang, Longtia, Dingi, Dingima picked their bags and hurried home. On the way, they stopped to drink water from a stream in a cup made of a bamboo, which was kept there. Today, not only the children, even Saima sir was in a hurry to get back. Today, there would be a special meeting of the village council, that is Panchayat. At the meeting, there would be a lottery to decide which family will get how much land for farming. The land belongs to the whole village, not to separate people. So, they take turns to do farming on different parts of the land. A beautiful pot made of bamboo was shaken well. One chit was taken out. Saima sir's family got the first chance. He said, "I'm happy that my family gets to choose first. But this year, we cannot take more land. Last year, I had taken more and was not able to farm it well. After my sister Jiri got married and went away, it is difficult to manage farming alone." Saima sir asked for 3 tin of land. Little Mathini asked, "What is 3 tin of land?" Chamui explained, "The land on which we grow 1 tin of seed is called 1 tin of land." One by one, the village families got their piece of land for farming. Zoom farming. Zoom farming is very interesting. After cutting one crop, the land is left as it is for some years. Nothing is grown there. The bamboo or weeds which grow on that land are not pulled out. They are cut and burned, the ash make the land fertile. While burning, care is taken so that fire does not spread to the other parts of the forest. When the land is ready for farming, it is lightly dug up, not plowed. Seeds are dropped on it. In one farm, different types of crops like maize, vegetables, chilies, rice are grown. Weeds and other unwanted plants are also not pulled out. They are just cut so that they get mixed with the soil. This also helps in making the soil fertile. If some family is not able to do farming on time, others help them and are given food. The main crop here is rice. After it is cut, it is difficult to take it home. There are no roads, only hilly paths. People have to carry the crop on their backs. This takes many weeks. When the work is over, the entire village celebrates. People get together to cook and eat, sing and dance. They do their special Chirao dance. In this dance, people sit in pairs in front of each other, holding bamboo sticks on the ground. As the drum beats, the bamboo are beaten to the ground. Dancers step in and out of the bamboo stick and dance to the beat. 3/4 people in Mizoram are linked to the forest. Life is difficult, but almost all the children go to the school. You can see some of them here playfully blowing their leaves whistles. You too have made many such whistles, haven't you?